On game day, the excitement begins when the Corps and the Fighting Texas Aggie Band march to the stadium. People line the streets as the Corps parades to the game. Inside the stadium, they pass in review before the university president, the commandant, and an invited reviewing officer. This time, it's Air Force General Patrick K. Gamble of the class of 1967. Proud parents and dates are always thrilled to see their cadets march by. The entire Corps is there, including Reveille and Parsons Mounted Cavalry, named for a former commandant. And after the cavalry is, of course, the cleanup crew. They, too, get a salute from the reviewing officer. It's time for kickoff and time for the team and the 12th man to really get busy. It's an Aggie tradition based on a real incident. In January 1922, the Aggies were playing in a bowl game called the Dixie Classic. And the Aggies were being hurt. There were a lot of injured Aggies on the team. And so a student came down to the stands, a student named E. King Gill. And he suited up right there on the sidelines. And when the game was over, he was the last Aggie there on the bench. And the Aggies won the game. And so since that time, Aggies have stood throughout the game to signify their willingness to go in and play in the game. It was such a famous incident that they built a statue to E. King Gill that stands right outside the entrance to Kyle Field. The students are always ready to suit up and go out there. And since 1983, one of them really has done that. On every Aggie kickoff, there is one player, a walk-on, a non-scholarship player, a student, the symbolic 12th man, who is in the game on every kickoff, representing all those other students who are up there yelling and standing ready for their turn. And all that yelling is important, too. Opponents say this is a tough place to play because of all that yelling, and we've got yell leaders that help.
And we have a really unique atmosphere here at Texas A&M because people are really frightened to come play here because the 12th man is so loud and so nice. And we just want everybody just to realize that the traditions here at Texas A&M are coveted by other schools because they wish that they could be as good as we are, but they're not. And so when they come here, they're not prepared. And when the 12th man gets loud, we get a lot of timeouts called. And what we as yell leaders do is try to encourage the crowd to be as loud as they possibly can.
Hi, I'm Blake Henshaw, class of 98. I'm a senior in Parsons Mounted Cavalry. And this here is the Parsons Mounted Cavalry Cannon Crew. And the way they're chosen, there's five members from every class. And the class is, consists of about 40 people in Parsons Mounted Cavalry, sophomore through senior. And those five guys from every class stand out on the field, and we take care of the cannon. We fire it every time that the Aggies score, and at the beginning of the game and at halftime. And the cannon, this was the spirit of 02. It was found in 1976 at a cut site, and it was totally restored by the Corps cadets and Parsons Mounted Cavalry, and we restored it, and we stock a lot of ammunition because we're going to beat the hell out of OSU today.
And there's another well-known Aggie tradition. When the Aggies score, it goes way back to when it was an all-male, all-military college here at Texas A&M, and the dates had to be bussed in for the football game. Speaking of dates, there's one group in an Aggie football game that has a really special situation. I wonder what it's like to be an Aggie band date.
Let's Being in Aggie Band Day is so exciting because it's like you're in the middle of one of the older traditions at A&M. You get to be right in the middle of the band and just be a part of something really special.
It is wonderful to be a Aggie Band date because I'm not an Aggie, and this is my first A&M game to be to, and I've got front row seats, and it's really awesome.
It's so exciting to be a date of the Aggie Band because you get to experience this in a way that no other Aggie gets to unless you're in the middle of it.
As far as I know, the Texas Aggie Band is the only college band that gets to have their date set with them. Another good reason to be in the Aggie Band. And this is the George Bush Presidential Library here on the Texas A&M University campus. This magnificent structure is opening this week to commemorate the administration of the 41st President of the United States. Thousands of people were here for the ceremony, including dignitaries from around the world and former presidents, and even the current President of the United States.
The sun is shining on Texas A&M today. And the sun is shining on America today. You know, we have an interesting country with a lot of religious, racial, and political diversity. Once in a while, we all get together. This morning, I think it's fair to say that all Americans are united in tribute to President George Bush for his lifetime of service to America.
And let me thank Dr. Ray Bowen and others here from the A&M fraternity, all of whom made this magnificent facility possible. In just a few minutes, this magnificent structure, as President Jimmy Carter said, paid for with private funds, will be handed over to former Governor John Carlin, the archivist of the United States, whereupon his capable team will operate it in this marvelous setting, right here on this Texas A&M campus, on behalf of the American people.
The Texas Aggie Band was there to take part in this historic event in Aggieland. Participation in the George Bush Presidential Library dedication was appropriate for the Texas Aggie Band because George Bush has been a fan of the Aggie Band for a long time. In fact, he invited them to participate in his inaugural parade back in 1989. And every time he has the opportunity, he has something good to say about the fighting Texas Aggie Band.
Well, only that I have such a high regard for it, and just at this very beginning of today, you hear this marvelous music and see this the corps come in. It's very emotional for me and very moving. And the band, I was telling the cadet here that they must be a great inspiration to these people in the athletics to hear all that, too. So it's a wonderful institution, 400 strong, and they have my respect and very high regard.
I'm excited about this and standing next to a double-dipped Aggie over here and our great senator, and it's going to be wonderful. Good game, I'm sure, and I can't wait to see the parade and to see that band again. I'll tell you, it is an amazing band.
And now it's game day, the end of a busy but proud week for the Texas Aggie Band. Pleased to be part of this historic week. And one member with the Texas Aggie Band that is particularly pleased to be part of this historic week and part of the dedication of the George Bush Presidential Library is Lieutenant Colonel Ray Toler, Director of Bands at Texas A&M. You see, Colonel Toler was invited to write a special march for the occasion. It's the George Bush Presidential March. And President Bush was so pleased with the march that he made a special presentation to Colonel Toler before the game.
During the 35 years of his professional career, Colonel Toler has performed for 8 city presidents, beginning with President Kennedy. These directions are intended to the 30-yard line, the West Island Way, for President George Bush, accompanied by Texas A&M University President Ray Bowen, are presenting the great assignment of right. The barge along with President Bush's personal note of appreciation.
Bonfire is topped by a little house. It looks like an outhouse, and it used to be the band's job to locate an actual outhouse to put on top of the bonfire. In modern times, they have to build one. They say it represents the University of Texas tea room. You see, Aggies refer to Longhorns as tea sips. And on bonfire night, the band is part of what makes that night a special event in Aggieland. That's right, the band has been playing, and they're circling, the torches are circling. Get ready to throw them right now. If you can see on the screen, the torch is moving, they're throwing them, getting ready to light. Here it is. The 1997 Texas Aggie Bonfire is getting ready to go up in flames.
And we will see it when it is lit. There's something at the very top that we haven't talked about yet this year, but it is a tradition as the bonfire is lit at the base and the flash bulbs popping all over, even though they don't really do much good. It sure is a pretty sight.
Yeah. Flash bulbs popping left and right of us. People trying to get a shot of this bonfire going up in flames. And it indeed is going up. And it's going up because it's been soaked with some petrol to help it get started. The truck moved out of here just before we went on the air.
because they've doused it pretty good, and so it ought to start. So it looks like one side is going pretty well and a little bit slower on the other sides. But it's going to burn up to the top to where that outhouse is on top.
That's what we
come out of that huddle toward that line of scrimmage, I hope they can't hear themselves talking on Kyle Field. I hope they come out, they see those 12-man towels going and see that sea of towels going up there. And I hope they hear you so loud that they can't hear themselves think.
Thank you.
band loaded onto university buses for the short trip to Texas A&M's Easterwood Airport. Then they boarded two 727 charter jets for the flight to Topeka, Kansas. The flight gave the band members a little time to study or to pursue other pastimes. Passing over America's heartland, the band landed at Topeka's Forbes Field. They unloaded the planes with only a brief timeout for football practice and headed to the hotel. After checking in, the band took a little excursion to the K-State neighborhood. As the sun went down, both the Kansas State people and the Aggies thought it was time to show a little spirit. On Saturday morning, we got up early for breakfast, and then it was time to head to the stadium. Fortunately, the instrument truck was there waiting for the band.
Jones Stadium. The nationally famous Boxing Texas Aggie Band. Thank you. tradition of the Y'all Rose of Texas.
Thank you.
pays tribute to the Texas Aggie 12th man with the 363-member block TAM.
Thank you. nationally famous Fighting Texas Aggie Band.
This will obviously be the only reason.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's only a band that's a half-hour show. 1997-98, the Fighting Texas Aggie Band. Famous Fighting Texas Aggie Band.
at the north end of the Southwestern Bell Combo. The nationally famous Fighting Texas Aggie Band.
Thank you.